Hi there, this is Ranjit from tech2pass.com, and in this video we're going to do the full review for this portable wireless router. And this is a travel router. I have already done the unboxing for this device, so you can check out that video to get an overview and what comes inside this box. And this is the actual device itself. It's slightly bigger than a credit card, but a little bit thicker. And the thing with this device is that you can use it in n number of ways. You can use it like a normal, Wi-Fi router. You can attach your broadband connection to this LAN port and thus use it like a normal Wi-Fi router. I tested with that. It also worked. But the main thing that you might be using this is by using a 3G data card. Sadly, you cannot just add a SIM card to it directly. You need a 3G data card. For example, I tested it with a 3G data card and a 3G service called ASL 3G for my testing, and it worked fine. But again, this is how it will look when you attach the 3G dongle to the same. We do also get some other things. Here we have this reset pin, and here we have the micro USB slot that will be used for charging it. The device has an inbuilt battery. Let me show you the same. You can just pry it open back like this. And again, the battery charge offered is kind of a mixed in my experience. When I was just using it like a normal Wi-Fi router by attaching my broadband connection, I was getting around 4.5 hours of battery life. But with the 3G data card, it significantly drops down, and you can get anywhere between 2 or 3 hours based upon your usage. You can also attach charger. We do get a charger with the same, but the thing is that as it's using a normal micro USB slot, you can actually use your mobile charger also to charge the device. And I used it like that, and it worked fine. The device heats up a little bit, and let me switch it on. Here we have this on-off toggle. And when we switch it on, you get these four LEDs. The first is for power, the second is for if you connect it via this wired port, third is Wi-Fi, and the last one is it shows if you're connected to the internet. To manage this device, you need to connect it to a computer and go to a browser-based utility. And from there, you can change between the different modes. For example, the 3G mode, the access point mode, the router mode, etc. And I'm going to show you the same now. Just fire up your web browser, and you need to go to 192.168.0.1. And the default username and password will be admin and admin. Actually, you need to first select the Wi-Fi network. By default, it will be TP-Link Pocket. And it will also have something else over here. I have just renamed the SSID. So you just need to connect to that and go to this page, and you'll see this page. As of now, I have set it to the 3G mode. And as you can see here, it's connected to my 3G dongle that I had showed earlier. You can see it shows that it's connected here. So let me show you the same. Let me open the Google homepage. And as you can see, we are connected. And from here, you can just go to this quick setup option. And here, from here, we can set up the various options. As you can see, I'm right now in the 3G router mode. You can also set it up like a normal router, that's wireless router mode. And you can also set it up as a standard AP mode. Here we have various options like repeating, etc. For example, let me show you the same. Hit that, you can hit next. And again, as you can see, we get various options. Again, in 3G also, we have various options. We can also set up the priority for, let's say you also have a wired internet connection, you can just set that also. For example, this option is also really cool, the last one, WAN preferred. For example, normally it's connected to the your wired ethernet. When that fails, it'll automatically switch to 3G. So those options are there. In my testing, it worked fine, but again, as I said, it's a 3G thing, so it depends upon your dongle also. With my ASL 3G data card, I was getting the speeds that I directly get while connecting to my laptop. The speeds I got were the same. I generally get about between 2 to 2.5 Mbps, and I got the same speeds using this TP-Link travel router. Again, as you can see, it's a full-fledged router, and you get all the settings that you want. So you have a lot of control over it. You can do parental control. You have set the security. For example, you have completely, you can set your wireless security to WPA, WPA2, etc. So in those terms, it's a full-fledged router, I would say. Again, I would say it's just a portable Wi-Fi router, and it reflects in the Wi-Fi coverage that it provides. Compared to a normal Wi-Fi router, I would say the coverage that this device provides is about 60 to 65%. Even at about 25 feet away from this device, I was able to connect to multiple Wi-Fi clients, and it worked fine. I tested a max of about 6 Wi-Fi devices, and it worked fine. So in terms of that, it is great. So as you can see, the biggest con that I feel about this device is that to change the mode, you have to come to this admin webpage again and again. And that's kind of a little bit of a bummer in my opinion. So what do I feel about this TP-Link battery operated travel router? Before that, let me talk about a few things. It's not particularly about this device, but for any 3G enabled device, for example, here we require an external 3G dongle. And I want to make one thing very clear is that go to the TP-Link website and make sure that the data card that you're going to use is compatible. I checked the TP-Link website and they have a lot of Huawei and ZTE data cards listed over there, and it works with even, what do you say, Reliance NetConnect, Tata Photon and Airtel, etc. But again, make sure that your data card is supported, because if it's not, there's a high chance that it might not work. For example, I'm using the Huawei E122. It's not listed, but still it works. But to be perfectly sure, I would say that just check that. I've posted the link in the YouTube show notes, so you can check out that for the data card compatibility. One more thing that I want to talk about is that regarding 3G setup, it's not automated. So you need to go to the control panel, as I showed before, and there you need to set it up. Sadly, I was using this Aircel 3G SIM card, and in the drop-down list, Aircel 3G was not there. But you have a manual option from there, which you can set it up, and I set it up easily. All the major providers like Airtel, BSL, etc. were listed. But again, I just wanted to point out that if your data provider is not there, you need to enter some manual settings. So that's kind of a bummer. They should have included all the major ISPs in the regions they provide the service. So that's also one more con. So how do I feel about this device? This is a great device by TP-Link, and the added advantage is that it's battery operated, so you just can carry it along with you. And it's ideal for people who travel a lot or get stuck in, what do you say, travel a lot, even in cars. I actually use this a lot in my car. We generally get have huge traffic jams in our city. We get stuck for hour or hour and a half. So I was using this a lot, and using this I could connect to my tablets, etc. So it's great for people like that who travel a lot. Apart from that, again, the battery life, again, as I said, is going to be varying. On 3G, I would get about 2 to 3 hours. It's a great device. The only con, as I said, is to change the mode from 3G to another, you need to go back to the, what do you say, control panel. And the only con that I have is this thing. Why do we need a data card? It would have been great if this device had a direct slot for a SIM. You just add in a SIM, because this way the device looks a bit clunky and you have to carry around two devices with you. Apart from that, it's great. I think so, this product sells in India for around 3,500. I hope you found this review helpful. That's it for now. This is Ranjit from TechToBuzz.com, and I hope to see you in my next video.